fly in my mouth. But that's what you get when you're a biker, you just gotta swallow and carry on. What's going on, guys? JamesTheBiker here today, and in this video I just want to start off by saying thank you to everyone who subscribed to me, and thanks for watching my videos. I hope you enjoy my content and stay tuned for more. So yeah, in today's motor vlog, guys, the topic is what stops you from riding your motorbike. Well, you may think to yourself, there's many ways and reasons why you might be stopped from riding your motorbike. I've had this recently because I haven't been uploading twice a week like I said I would be, because I've been stopped from riding my motorbike. And there's I think there's three main reasons, but yeah, there's reasons for that. And those reasons are, every time I've gone to ride my motorbike, it's been raining, and it just really puts me off going, because I'm like still a learner, and I don't really want to slide out because I haven't done much wet weather riding, so I don't really want to slide out. But that's one reason, because the rain all the time. I'm there. Oh, you know what? I feel like making a motor vlog today. I'm gonna go out on my bike, just have a nice cruise, and chat to you guys. I done that, went out, got my bike out of the garage, started up, let it warm up for a bit. I got changed, got my jacket on, got my helmet on, and just about got my bike, and then you know what? The bloody rain tips now. I can't handle this, guys. All the time. It's like five times I was going to come out. Rain, 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 rain. And you know what, guys? I'm fed up with rain. I'm glad we've actually got some sunshine, but I don't know how long it'll hold for, because the clouds are still like looking dark and it's gonna rain. It was raining earlier, but you know what, guys? I'm just taking a chance today. I don't care if it rains or not, but hopefully it done. So yeah, that's that reason. And then you have the second reason, is because, if you notice, I'm wearing a different motorbike jacket, and that is because my jacket, my zip broke. So I was trying to zip it up. I think I kept trying to zip it up, but like the teeth on the jacket and the zip was like not there. Like they just been like knocked off somehow and they're missing. So that's why I couldn't go out another time. And I couldn't be asked to put this jacket on because it's boiling hot, and in this jacket I just get sweltering. So that's why I should wear my other jacket in the summer. But yeah, that happened, so that stopped me riding. We took it down this place, ordered a new zip. I think it should be ready today, actually, so I'll pick that up later. fly in my mouth. But that's what you get when you're a biker, you just gotta swallow and carry on. Anyway, yeah, so I'm gonna pick up my KTM jacket later on, my summer jacket, because then I'll be comfortable in that. But then today it's not too bad in this jacket. It's nice and cool because it looks like it's gonna rain, but hopefully it doesn't. Yeah, so yeah. And the third reason, what was the third reason? Oh yeah, my bike wouldn't start. That was the third reason. And the reason why it wouldn't started was because I left it in the garage for so long. Well, not so long, well, when it's been raining and stuff, and when it's all this hot weather, I went to try and start it, but obviously it didn't start, and I think the reason was because I didn't get enough petrol flowing around in the tank, so I was kicking it over like once or twice, then trying to like start it with the ignition on. And what probably happened was that in the hot weather, in the heat, it evaporated the petrol, which was actually in my engine. So the pistons would go up and down and work itself. So it like done that to my petrol, evaporated it, and obviously the petrol wasn't going around enough. So that's why I had trouble starting my bike, and that's another reason why I couldn't go out on my bike. So yeah, I figured it out. I think then one other time I flooded the engine a bit, and the spark plug was all wet, so it wouldn't spark, and that was another reason why. So I had to undo the spark plug, clean it up a bit, dry it off, and then you know what, guys, it worked. So in the end, I know what to do now if I ever had that problem again, so that's a good thing. So yeah, that's that. That's my three things. Why? You can obviously have other reasons, like if a family member died, but then that's just normal. Not normal, like that's just obviously you won't be going out then. Just take some time off. So yeah, that's my three reasons why I haven't, why I couldn't go out on my bike. So my topic today was somewhere around, like, what was it? I can't remember. I said it at the start. I'll remember it again, or I'll just like copy that bit at the start and put in this bit. But it was like reasons why you can't ride your bike. Or no, that's what I'm asking you guys. Comment below, like, if you've had similar problems, or like just tell me reasons why you couldn't ride your bike. Have you had problems like me? It wouldn't start, your engine fail, just stuff like that, guys. Just comment below so I can interact with my viewers and just, you know, that sort of stuff. So it'd be pretty good. So yeah, guys, thanks for watching this video. This has been James the Biker. Please like, comment, share and subscribe. And yeah, peace out, guys. Ride safe.